today's video, Cryptohopper. Let me answer some of the questions that you've been asking me now for a while. And also, on today's video, I will show you a very small and interesting modification that I did to one of my strategies that will increase your profit. I think you will like this. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are having a wonderful day. If you are new to this channel and you like making money in crypto, well, make sure you hit the subscribe button if you don't want to miss any of my future video. So yes, I did one modification to one of my strategies. Actually, it's the EMA 30. So any one of you that are using the EMA on 30 minutes, I will show you something that I changed and that increase your profit. So let's go over to the computer and I will show you exactly what I did. If this is your first video on Cryptohopper and you want to get more detail about it, I'll put a link right here on top so you can have my introduction video on Cryptohopper. I will also put a link below in the description if you want to access their platform and register for a free 15 days trial. All right, so let's go back to the platform. All right, so let's go back to the dashboard. So let me show you exactly. So like I said, I did a small modification on the EMA 30 minutes. And what it does, it just increased your profit on the long run. So it takes a little bit longer, but the profit you're making per trade are higher. So let me show you on the trade history. And don't look too much right here. I have a couple stop loss. My stop loss for this strategy was too low. It's not like the regular EMA 30 minutes. And I will explain you why. So the stop loss has to be higher. And I did check those. And more than half of those stop loss wouldn't be there if I would have put my stop loss at 15%. But if you look at the profit that I've been generating for the last week or so, like this one, I have 13% right here, 8% here, 15%, 10%, 22% on this one, 13% on this one, 7, 12, 4, almost 15% right here, 15% right here. So as you can see, the profit are a lot higher. Like I said, yes, I do have a couple stop loss, but it's because the stop loss was just too low for that strategy. So if you increase it, most of them won't be there and you would be a lot more in profit. So let me show you the strategy that I use. So first of all, I just did a copy of the EMA 30 minute that we were using. So if you want to do a copy and keep this, keep the original one, all you have to do, open up your strategy, go here, save as a copy, rename it, and then save it again. So you'll have the same strategy as this one, but under a different name. So this one, we can modify it. Let me go back to mine so I can show you. So I rename mine EMA plus RSI on the 1 hour. And that strategy has to be on 1 hour. I don't recommend you using it under 30 minutes. So what I did for the buy portion, the only thing you have to change, it's right here, chart period, 1 hour. All the rest stayed the same. So it would be close, 10:50, and necessary signal right here. On the sell, you have to create a new indicator. So you go to indicator, type RSI, and you need to use this one with region crossover. So let's select it. And when it's selected, go here, change your period to 1 hour, necessary signal, and then close 14:30:70, and then the signal in, and keep signal four, do not keep the signal. Make sure you save, and that's it. So let me show you exactly what this strategy is doing. So let's go on the chart right here, and I have Atom. Make sure I'm on the 1 hour candle. So let's see, let me show you. So the buy portion, it would happen when the EMA 10 cross over the EMA 50. So if we look, actually, let me change that so I only see my 10 and 50. So as we can see, I have four lines. I have the 10, 20, 50, and 100. So I'm just keeping the number one and the number three. So it's this one and this one. I click OK. So every time the 10 cross over the 50, it signals a buy. So right here, I would enter a position right at this point. And the selling signal apply only when the RSI cross below the 70. So my RSI is right here at the bottom. So I would enter a position right here. And as you follow my line right here, so the price will keep going. And then when the RSI go back or leave the region outside or go back in below the 70, it send a sell signal. So it would let it go, and right here it would sell. So if we look at the profit, it would probably be from here up to here. So that would be a 9% profit on this trade. Let's look another example. So let's say I enter a trade right here, and actually I will show you, let me go, how about this one? Yeah, actually this one. So I enter a trade when it cross over right here, and I sell when the RSI go below the 70, which would be right here. So that would be about 7.7% profit. So that's the way, that's how that strategy is working. Now for the stop loss, it's very important to have a higher stop loss because of the volatility of the market and the way the market is currently going. To have a volatility of like 8 or 10%, it's normal. So if you have a stop loss too low, like my example I just show you at 8%, the stop loss was stopping my trade too soon and too often. So let me show you actually where we could have a good example. Maybe I'm trying to find where the RSI doesn't cross and that I'm getting actually right here, it could be a good example. So let's say I enter a trade right here. So my 10 crossed the 50 right here. It goes up to about 10%. But as you can see, the RSI didn't cross the 70. So now it's dumping. And as you can see, it can go pretty low. So right here, it goes up to 10.6%. So having a stop loss at 8%, like it was before, what I would have sold right there. If you put the stop loss at 15%, you're still fine. Your position is still open. So when the market start to go back up again, and as you can see, my RSI right here is crossing down. So I would have sell right here. So that would have been a 6.5% profit instead of having a stop loss of 8%. So this is why it's very important to increase your stop loss on this strategy. Now, the question on if you should put or not a stop loss. I know some of you have been telling me, well, we are in a bull market, so why should we put a stop loss? Yes, I do understand that right now, while I'm recording this video, we are in a bull market. But if you're watching this video 6 months down the road or a year down the road, I don't know what the market will look like. And even though right now we are in a bull market, let me show you an example of what happened in the last week if there was no stop loss. So let's say on the Atom token, I would have a buy signal right here, actually right there. Let me reduce this so we can see properly. So that was on April 16, there was a buy signal. So I enter my position right here, and then a couple hours after, like 14 hours after, the market start to go down. And as you can see, my RSI never sent a sell signal. So market go down, 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 and went up to almost 35%. And then it start to recover a little bit. And then it start to go down again at 30%, start to recover, and it keep going down and down and down and down. And even today, right now, I would be still at minus 15% in loss. So if you don't put your stop loss, yeah, there's a good chance that Atom will probably go back soon and then you'll start to make profit. So you just have to decide for yourself. Do you want to take the chance of having a coin that start to go down for a long period of time and you don't know if it will go up, or you accept the loss, let's say at 15% right here, stop loss, and then when the market recover, like in this example, the EMA 10 cross over the 50, you re-enter a brand new position from here and you let it go. So even right here, I would be at 15% profit in one day. So this is up to you guys. If you don't want to use a stop loss and you want to take the chance, or you know, since we are in a bull run or in an uptrend market, that your coin will go back, well, don't use a stop loss or use something very, very high if you want to. But personally, I prefer to have a stop loss, so it would stop like somewhere right here. And when the market recover, well, at least I can re-enter a brand new position and make profit from here instead of waiting for the coin to go back up. But like I said, if you want to use this strategy that I'm talking about, make sure you put a stop loss at least at 12, 14 or 15%. Personally, I put it at 15%, but it's up to you. Put whatever you want. But if you put it too low, you will get a lot of stop loss. All right. And the other question I want to answer also very quickly, all the fees from your exchange are already included in your profit. Let me show you very quickly, because a lot of you have been asking me, what are the fees? Did you include your fees from your exchange? So let me show you right here this example. So just transaction. I did on it 4.99% profit. So let me show you how Cryptohopper calculate the profit. So let's open up the trade, go to the buy order. So as you can see, the buy order, my investment was $1,039.679. This amount was after the fee. So probably my investment was like $1,040. But because I have to pay some fee, from that case, it was a Kraken. Well, the net investment is $1,039. And when it sell, as you can see, this amount you see right here is after my fee from Kraken. So Cryptohopper take the buy. So it calculate the cost, the net cost after the fees versus the net cost after it sold, and this is how it calculate the profit. So yes, the profit you're making always include your fees from your exchange, and that's why I always say that it's very important to choose an exchange where you pay as minimum fee as possible. And let me go very quickly on the config. And by the way, I'll put the link up here just to show you, if this is your first time you're watching one of my video and you would like to have more detail about those strategies, I'll put a link here on my two popular strategies that I did, which is the EMA and also the Bollinger Band strategy. So let me still go over the configuration I did for that new strategy. So from here, so the buy setting, so that's up to you. So maximum open time to buy, it's 4 minutes. Order type, I always use the market. Why? Because I want to have the transaction happening right now. So I assume there's a buy signal. I want to have the buy transaction happening now. I don't want to wait for a certain amount of time if you choose the limit order. maximum open position. So in my case, I set it to 12 open position. You can put it whatever you want, depending on what's the amount you're having available for your Cryptohopper. Maximum percentage open position per coin. So I would like to have only one. So usually I'll change the slider here until I see the number one right here. And it will cool down. I like to use the cooldown and only after buys for a cooldown of 60 minutes. Only one open buy order per coin. Coin and amount, make sure you have your coin right here. Percentage buy amount. So this is what percentage do you want to use from your total available amount on your exchange. Let me give you an example. You have $1,000 available on your exchange. Well, you can tell your hopper to use 20% of that $1,000 per trade. If you have an exchange with, let's say, $10,000 on it, but you only want your hopper to use 1,000 of the whole 10,000, well, you would have to enter right here $1,000. So what this does is, even though you have like 5,000, 10,000, or it doesn't matter how much you have on your exchange, Cryptohopper will only use up to a maximum of this amount right here. Strategy. So make sure you have the proper strategy right here. So the one we have just created, and then stop buy. I use the stop buy. This is up to you if you want to use it, but I put enable and I put 0.2% here. Sell setting. I put my take profit at 50% because actually I don't really want this sell setting to kick in. I don't want that to happen. I prefer to use the RSI only. And same thing. Order type, market, sell strategies. This is now very important. You need to activate the sell based on strategy because I want to use my RSI signal to sell my position. So this one is very important. Stop loss. So right now mine is at 15%. I really recommend to have at least 15% right here. Trailing stop loss. I do activate the trailing stop loss, but I put it higher because then again I prefer to have the RSI selling, but like right now, since the market been playing around for a while, I do put the trailing stop loss at 12% with a trailing percentage here at 3%. But then again, it's up to you if you want to use it or not, but in my case I do use it, and all the other are not being used. So make sure if you change anything, go back here and you click on the save so you can save all your configuration. So I hope this will help you. I hope that you have a better understanding on how it works. Give it a try, see how it performs for you. Like I said, stop loss, very important. Trailing stop loss, use whatever you think you want to use, and make sure you use on the 1 hour chart. This is very important. I hope you have a wonderful day, guys. And by the way, thank you very much. I'm well over the 2000 subscribers right now. I think I'm 2200 subscribers. Thanks everyone for subscribing to my channel. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you very soon on the next one. Thank you and bye-bye.